recollection.
You still have all the woods.
And we first looked at
the house in the corner of our house. The house that would be in line with the property that was in town.
Which was a farm and a nice house.
The town that we grew up in.
And the relatives of the original.
Farm town. And there was about an acre of land behind it. To see evidence of a stone wall. Farm rock wall to.
The property that we.
A lot of trees. And it also was to create.
A house that was under construction.
Property was up against an old farm. And it was no longer being used that way. So it was pretty private as far as houses on our block, on our street when. And I remember from a young age, my father spent a lot of time in the woods. And he used the woods as kind of an escape.
And beyond the stone wall.
But while he was in there, he did things like dig up rocks, create pathways, build small ponds, and kind of created a karate training
property.
That I never really saw him use, not to say that I would have.
It had nice little path that went all the way around
wooded area.
The woods on that property.
And I enjoyed very much taking walks in that property. And so when I saw the wooded area behind the house that we were building, I was pleased that there was some woodlands and some old farmers' fields behind that.
I had a great kind of desire to.
An 80s development
in the woods, and all the houses were.
Once we had moved in,
what he was doing,
I thought it would be a good idea.
I really enjoyed the maze of paths and walking through it and having that kind of clearing made before me. We had a little jungle gym that was treacherous to actually use, but I do remember using it as a way of
boys age that.
Pretty heavily wooded, and that could be dressed up with some
my own privacy, a little bit of woods,
evergreen types of plants,
hang out in the woods and hope
eventually
to get
noticed, a pond. So one of the things I began doing was kind of cutting a path
why I
through there
in the woods
and picking up
my memory of
we used to be witches. We would go out in the woods and we would collect berries and we'd make
paths.
I would make porridges. Chop suey. We pretend to cook. We play house. I think my brother had tried to build a fort out of like four trees that were back there. He tried to build something and he kind of gave up. So there was just like a couple of boards that had been nailed up. And it kind of made our little makeshift house. And I remember there being a log that had fallen and it sort of rotted
there,
out. And there was a part of the log that had kind of like a divot in
the
it.
The ground, the leaves, the debris that had fallen against it got to be probably 2 feet deep from the present time down to where the base of the wall was. The other thing about it was that it was a good place for snakes to go in and hide. The only really big project that I did there is as I was foraging for stones and so forth. There was one place in the past that there was what looked like a fairly small stone that turned out to be quite a bit older. And after several weeks of
he really enjoyed spending time in the woods, and we used to go for walks in the woods together. Not necessarily on our property yet, but and you know he really loved to build paths and build stone walls and dig up rocks and. He made a pond, and he had this really cool, like, stone
recollection of the place was that
next to the pond,
along the right side of that
I think he really connected it
land
like,
space or forested space
and so the woods,
were the backyards of three other houses in the area.
As,
and
as a,
I tried to leave that as
was kind of a buffer. And
So it was kind of a sad spot in what was otherwise, you know, a happy place in which we lived. I think people have some kind of primal thing in their DNA that wants them to be associated with natural surroundings and being able to go into those natural surroundings whenever they can. You know, I've often thought that's one of the reasons why people bring plants and flowers into their houses, and also try to develop places outside their houses that are kind of controlled natural environments. But I'm not sure everybody feels that way, but for me it's been always very pleasurable from time to time. Regularly to go out and just simply walk in
the woods behind the house.
And I especially enjoy places that are
at nighttime,
very natural,
scary place where
the natural ingredients are foliage and water and stars and places where you can look at over the sky and places where it's very dark and white. I'm not sure everybody enjoys that, but I suspect that they do.
Either way, it was where I could be mysterious.
In the absence of such, I think what we try to do is recreate those places, not in our mind, to the best of our capability in terms of where we live. It's more than a gardening thing. It's something that gives us connectedness. In a concrete world, we like to not forget completely those places that we live that are,
the woods really
that we are natural, that are also natural to us. So those are my recollections of that particular place, and irrespective of where I've ever lived, that has been something that appeals to me. Of course, I grew up in a place where those kinds of places were very hard to find.
Wonder if that's
still so later in life, when I have had a choice and been more mobile, whether I've had those places as part of my immediate living circumstances, or whether I've had to get in a car and drive to those places, I've always enjoyed that.
And that's what I remember.